Now, I caught up with Nouriel Roubini, Mr. Doom, and he says he's never been so pessimistic about the Eurozone, but he also has severe concerns about the global economy as a whole.
My main scenario is one of a U-shaped pandemic recovery rather than a double dip W. So I see the higher probability of a slow recovery in the advanced economies, but I see also risk of a double dip rising, especially if there is a policy mistake like exiting too soon from the stimulus or exiting too late. So that's a tough choice for policymakers. If you exit too soon, you end up back into recession deflation. If you exit too late, we run away fiscal deficit and demonetization. You have a fiscal train wreck and or high inflation down the line. So those are some of the challenges, like the exit from these policy stimulus.
Are you concerned about that? Is there a chance that we exit too soon? Just because it seems that actually we're not coordinating our movements as such or as much as a lot of people wanted. It seems that we've kind of broken away from the G20 as a whole.
Yes, you know, in the case of the U.S., I don't see an exit too soon. The policymaker U.S. say we shouldn't exit too soon. But, for example, in the Eurozone, the monetary policy of the ECB has been tighter than the United States. They might exit sooner than the U.S. And on the fiscal side, you have already large budget deficit and accumulation of public debt. They imply many of these countries have to retrench fiscally sooner rather than later. So there is a risk of an early exit. In the case of China, again, it's difficult to say they're starting to tighten because the economy is overheating and inflation is going up. They might not tighten enough, or they might tighten too much. We don't know yet how much it's going to be. But definitely, it's not a coordinated exit. That means there'll be also strain on currencies. It's going to lead to currency tensions, for example.
What does it mean, first of all, for the markets? Because I know we've talked before, and you've always said, well, the market is just going too fast, too furiously. That's what you told me just a couple of months ago. And we do seem to have, for example, in Hong Kong, that market losing 8% since the beginning of the year. Is that sort of a correction that we're going to see elsewhere in the world?
If China's going to tighten very much, too much, too soon, then there's a risk that's going to be a market correction throughout Asia and also in other parts of the world. A lot of the growth of Asia has been driven by the recovery of China. Now China is overheating. They're behind the curve. They have to tighten. They've kept on doing it. If they do more of it and too much of it, that could be a slowdown of growth in China and globally, and that's going to be negative for the markets as well.